singing. I'm in a library and I'm singing. I'm in a library and I'm singing.
Hi, how are we all doing today?
Yeah.
Good, good. Well, thank you, Dad. My name is Buddy, okay? We're gonna read for you a little bit, and then after that we're gonna get some questions about the North Pole and living with Santa and the elves, okay? Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna read first. This is one of my favorite books in the whole world. It's called Little Santa. Has anyone read this book yet? Okay, you guys are in for a treat. Are you ready? Let's get started. All right, this is Little Santa. Okay. Can everyone see? In the North Pole, in a little log cabin, lived Mr. and Mrs. Claus and their 7 children, Larry, Mary, Willie, Millie, Joey, Zoe, and Santa. Life was tough in the North Pole. Every day there was more wood to be chopped, more snow to be shoveled, another fish to be caught, a quilt to be mended, and a fire to be stoked. The Clauses were miserable. Except for Santa. He loved the North Pole. He liked making snow angels and snowmen and decorating pine trees and baking gingerbread cookies in the shapes of people. Most of all, he liked sliding down the chimney. So, when the Clauses decided to move to Florida, Santa was very sad. Have any of you been to Florida before? It's very warm there. Oh, we have lots of questions about Florida. Okay. Just 1 second, okay? We'll get all questions after, okay? Cool. So, they're going to Florida, but Santa was very sad. Won't you miss all the pine trees and the icicles and miles of snow? No, Santa, they said, we won't. That night, everyone packed, and there was a terrible blizzard. The next morning, the house was buried under a huge snowdrift, and the Clauses were trapped. What are we gonna do? Said Mrs. Claus. I know, said Santa. I can shimmy up the chimney. So, Mr. and Mrs. Claus gave Santa some food and some snowshoes and sent him up to get help. And after a long walk, he came to a little branch. Ho, 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 said Santa. You must be the top of a tall tree. No, said the voice, I'm a very cold reindeer. Santa dug the reindeer out of the snow. Gosh, said the reindeer, what are you doing out here? Santa told the reindeer about his family. And the reindeer said, hop on my back, we'll look for help. Gee whiz, said Santa, you're a pretty special reindeer. On a tall bluff, they saw a house. A light was on inside. Stop here, said Santa. And the reindeer landed, and Santa slid down the chimney. The house was full of elves. Holy snowflakes, said the oldest one. Who are you? Santa introduced himself and told the elves about his family. We can help, said the elves. We'll make shovels so we can dig them out of the snow. In no time at all, the shovels were made. Now, Santa, said the elves, how will we get to your house? I've got a flying reindeer, said Santa. Wow, said the elves, and do you have a sleigh too? And Santa was confused. He said, what's a sleigh? I guess we're gonna have to build one. And here are the elves building the sleigh for Santa Claus. And the next morning, it was all finished. Santa hooked up the reindeer, and everyone climbed aboard. Ready, said the reindeer. Ready, said Santa. And off they went to look for Santa's house. Far away, the Clauses were waiting for Santa's return. It was almost midnight when the dog heard a familiar noise coming from the chimney. Could it be? Ho, 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 said Santa, I'm home. And the Clauses were overjoyed. But there was more noise coming from just outside. And when Santa opened the door, look, everyone, said Santa, these are my new friends. And Santa's family welcomed them. Well, it was a good year at the North Pole. The Clauses and the elves spent lots of time together, and life wasn't as tough as it was before. But when winter came, Santa's family decided to go to Florida after all. But
Santa Claus stayed behind. And you know the rest of the story. And that is the story of how Santa Claus came to be.
Can everyone see? Okay. It's Christmas Eve morning and everything's set. So why hasn't Santa Claus woken up yet? Santa Claus, time to get up. Some hot cocoa, please, in my jumbo size cup. I'm stuffy, I'm sneezy, I'm slow as a Yeti. My big ho, ho, ho isn't holiday ready. We must cancel Christmas. Oh, what a disgrace. I have a solution. I'll go in your place. So Mrs. Claus quickly assembled a crew. She mapped out a route from Taiwan to Peru. She made a supply list and checked on the weather. The elves helped her gather the presents together. They gave her the list and they packed her some snacks, then loaded up all of the boxes and sacks. Then Mrs. Claus bravely climbed onto the sleigh. Don't worry, she said, I will save Christmas Day. With a snap of the rein, she shot into the night. Merry Christmas to all. Wish me good luck on this flight. After some flying, they spied the first town. She called to the reindeer, let's start heading down. She gracefully shimmied through the chimneys with ease, arranging the presents beneath all the trees. This job is so simple, in fact, it's delightful. But soon the wind swirled and the weather turned frightful. She flew through tornadoes, then blizzards and sleet, which nearly blew Mrs. Claus off of her seat. The ride became bumpy and things started squeaking. She saw that the fuel in the sleigh had been leaking. Keeping her calm, she stayed in control. She stuffed in some ribbon to plug up the hole. They skidded through Sweden and bounced around Spain, then galloped to Texas and zoomed up to Maine. Look out, shouted Rudolph, an incoming duck. Poor Prancer pulled left and his bridle got stuck. A rein became twisted around the vixen's head, which made them start traveling southbound instead. She had to act fast to untangle the rein. I may not have magic, but I've got a brain. The problem now conquered, they got back on track. She felt one more present still left in the sack. I'll send it straight down. It's our very last one. Then Mrs. Claus hollered, we're finally done! With Rudolph's nose leading the way through the air, they reached the North Pole with 10 minutes to spare. She entered the workshop and, to her delight, discovered the elves had been waiting all night. They lifted her up as they shouted, hooray! Our old Mrs. Claus has just saved Christmas Day. And then she fell asleep. The end.
Well, we don't have any polar bear problems ourselves, but I know that Jack Frost has had some issues, okay? So it's something to watch out for, but all the polar bears that we've come across are very nice.
Okay.
Right. To get to the North Pole? Well, it depends how you travel. I usually go by magic sleigh, so that only takes about 10 minutes or so. However, last time I walked and I went on an ice, so that's pretty long. It's actually 3,408 miles to get from the North Pole to New York, which is where we're originally from. But if you take the George Washington Bridge instead of the Lincoln Tunnel, it's actually a mile shorter. A chocolate bar, put it in the hot chocolate. And then when it melts, it'll be more chocolate. It is amazing. All right. So this is one of my favorite songs to sing, okay? It's really easy. The words are, I'm singing, I'm in a library, and I'm singing. Okay? I'm singing, I'm in a library, and I'm singing. I'm in a library, and I'm singing. Very good. Dashing through the snow, and in one horse open sleigh. O'er the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells unlocked till ring, making spirit bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Very nice, everybody.
Here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Singing, singing, all his reindeers pulling on the reins. Bells are ringing, children singing, all is merry and bright. So hang your stockings and say your prayers, cause Santa Claus comes tonight. Here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. He's got a bag that's filled with toys for boys and girls again. Hear those sleigh bells jingle, jangle. So jump in bed and cover your head, cause Santa